Aloha Manga Club. Have you ever read anything online that didn't quite feel like a manga, but absolutely was not an American comic? Well, I have good news for you. That was either a webtoon or a manhwa, and they are absolutely breathtaking when you get down to it. A lot of them come in full color, they are much longer pages, and they split them up into seasons instead of arcs and chapters, which is just weird to me. But I love them either way. So today what I want to do with you is share my top 10 from both of these categories so you can get introduced and really enjoy some of my favorite works. But first, let's change location because it is a little bit echoey in here. And we are back in the regular location with the regular lighting, the regular sound, and same old attractive me. Sorry, my inner Lockhart is showing. Now let's kick this top 10 list off with number 10. Because you can't start a top 10 with number 9. So number 10 is Half Prince or One Half Prince. I have the same title issue as I did with Ranma Half / One Half. Now this story is all about a girl who goes into the video game world, aka an isekai, as a male because she just wants to play and enjoy the game without worry of dudes hitting on her. Now, I've never had that problem in the games because when I played RuneScape, you couldn't tell who was a guy and who was a girl. But in this one, they are living through their characters. Now, she does go through some misadventures as people randomly fall in love with her in both worlds and don't know who her character actually is. The battles were pretty fun. However, there was one problem. I did forget that it was ongoing for a little while, so I actually ended up dropping it just because I forgot. But it is a great one, so check out Half Prince. Now we are on to number 9, and that is Combat Continent. Now this one has a part 1 and a part 2. Both are pretty fun, however, they do suffer from some pacing issues, and I believe some translation issues as well. The story starts off with the MC basically getting reborn into another body that has a really, really weak ability in this world. He has the skill to control grass, and not just any grass, bluegrass. Yeah, pretty lame, I know. But it was a fun story. The action set pieces were really unique and inventive. They had a few different feeling arcs, and really you got to see how the character scaled up over time, but they also had a reasonable time jump, so you weren't just grinding it out with him the entire way. Now, like I said, there were a few issues. It does seem to skip around and miss some chapters here and there, but overall, it is absolutely a blast to read and I recommend it. Now, number 8 and number 7 are two very highly acclaimed and probably two of the most popular manhwa / webtoons out there right now. Number 8 is The Gamer, all about a kid who discovers that he has the ability to basically be a video game character in real life. He's able to grind like an RPG, not an RPE, and he has just tons of skills and abilities. He's basically way too OP in his world. The artwork, the coloring, all of it is absolutely unique, absolutely beautiful. And what can I say, if you are not reading The Gamer, you're missing out on one of the most popular manhwa that has ever been created. Now, number 7 is arguably the most popular one right now, and that is, forgive the pronunciation, but Noblesse, N-O-B-L-E-S-S-E. Now, this follows the story of Edward Cullen as he tries to get Bella, wrong vampire story. This is about an ancient vampire who is reawoken in, I believe, Seoul, South Korea, and his day-to-day life trying to blend in with society while also fighting off and regaining control of the vampire and werewolf hordes. He does not sparkle. He has pretty OP abilities, and at times he reminds me of Ukiura from Bleach just because of his character design and a little bit of his brooding personality. All in all, I really, really enjoy this manhwa, and like I said, there's a reason it is one of the most popular right now. It's just been going on for a while, and its panels are absolutely breathtaking. Now, number 6 is probably going to be one of the most argumentative ones that I am putting on this list, and that is Defense Devil. Now, this is all about basically a devil who becomes a lawyer to regain his devil abilities. Really weird concept, but a lot of the fight scenes are fun, though they do feel repetitive in the end. But this story really stuck with me just because it was a lawyer who was literally a devil, like a demon. And who doesn't want that in a manga or a comic book? Now, number five is the 100% reigning king, One Punch Man.
Can you do that two lists in a row?
Maybe. It's my list, so yes, I can. Because I'm using the actual webtoon of it from the creator one. The story, again, y'all know about it. Y'all know that the artwork is weird looking, but it is such a character piece. You'd be remiss not to flip through the pages and enjoy it. Now, we're entering my top four. Now, my top four is 100% controversial, and I think that there are going to be a few argumentative pieces about it, 100%. Number four is Witch Hunter, the story that started off so strong, but has started to fizzle out in the end. Now, why is this number four? Because I think the first half is absolutely bloody brilliant, and if you enjoy over-the-top gun battles, if you enjoy witches and, you know, Arthurian legend, this has got it all for you. There's Merlin, who used to be a guy but then became a girl in some weird magic experiment because he wanted more magical power. There's Arthur, who kind of looks like a lion. It's a very weird story, but the action was fun. The characters felt so connectable in the artwork. The artwork was so unique. It's like something that I hadn't seen before. Sorry about that, camera issues. Now let's go to number three. Now number three is absolutely one of the most breathtaking and really stunning manhwa that I have ever seen. The color was like a watercolor painting. The characters all looked really unique and beautiful, even the ugly ones. It was just stunning. And obviously, for number three, I'm talking about Feng Shen Ji, part one and part two. Now, this whole series is insane. It's dark. Let me give you an idea, a taster of chapter one. We are introduced to basically the main character's dad, who is going to go up and fight gods because the gods don't agree with what he's doing. Obviously, he is going to lose. He gets his brains bashed in. Then the boy's mother stabs him murders him to save his life because he is going to be transferred into a dead body that died at the same time as him, which happened to be a slave that he blinded a few years previously in the story. Yeah, that's not complicated. That's not dark. But it also turns out that the gods are part of the main character's family as well. Cannot get any more confusing than that. This whole story is violent. It is incredibly, incredibly cool to see how the main character grows and progresses as this spoiled, selfish individual to a great and powerful leader, like legitimately earth-shattering, mountain-breaking, powerful leader. It's so fun and beautiful to read, and each fight feels visceral and it feels real. Number two on this list is my absolute guilty pleasure manhwa. It is not that well drawn. It is amazingly written though. And that is Ares, basically the god of war. If you couldn't get it from just that title alone, this entire manhwa is based around a mercenary, like 15-year-old who wants to become the absolute best. And he wants to do that by being the absolute best sword fighter there has ever been. And you know what? He is really, really darn good. Like I said, the artwork isn't great, but what this story doesn't have in art, it makes up for in a beautifully fun written story that takes you to some very dark places that explore the true meaning of friendship. And it answers questions that you didn't even know that you had about war. Like, I didn't know that I had these questions about war. And realistically, this whole thing is impossible, but it is beautiful and great. And if you get the chance to read Ares the manhwa, please, please do. It's stunning. Now, I do want to give you one runner-up, and that is Uchino Mao Kamimasen Yo. I have made a video about that. It is adorable, heartwarming. It's about a boy and his pet, the Demon Lord. Look for it up here. You should read it. But number one was probably one of the most popular manhwa from 2015. One of the greatest martial arts kung fu manhwa that has ever been created. And honestly, I would put it up there in some of the best manga ever just drawn and written. And that is The Breaker and The Breaker New Waves. Now, technically, they are two different titles, two different seasons, but these are the same to me. They are, oh my god, the combat is insane. Each kick, you feel it reflected upon you. And the power scaling goes up steadily so you don't even know it, but they're doing things that just seem physically impossible. Our main character, Shion, is a bullied child because, well, he's kind of weak. Like, really, really weak. And he's also a coward. He doesn't know what to do with it, but he knows that he wants to stand up for others. And he meets his teacher, the Nine Arts Dragon, and basically by accident, really, gets taught kung fu, gets taught martial arts, and becomes this absolute monster. Like, he enters this world and slowly progresses from novice to masterclass violently, aggressively. It shows the butterfly transformation from this shy, cowardly Shion to what he becomes at the end of part two. The only disappointing thing is that we are currently waiting for part three to be created. And it's heartbreaking because I've been waiting for like 4 years. But part one and two are absolutely worth the read. So 100% check them out. Hopefully you liked my list of top 10. If you have any, let me know in the comments down below. And for everyone new and old, welcome and welcome back. It's your boy Lohali, signing out.